Hello, this is, Darth Vader here, and I'm, currently looking through the, latest, Correllian, totally not legally modified freighter catalog, and, so yeah, I got some pretty interesting stuff in here. Old, used, or a lot of cases, really, really used, like this ship is like literally old, 200 years old. So, and modified beyond all possible recognition from its stock. So yeah, and I mean, like, Correllian ships are just cool because they're modular. This also makes them an incredible pain in the ass because you never know when one of them's going to suddenly grow laser cannons or missile launchers and start shooting at you during a perfectly legal, legally authorized stop that has nothing to do with the fact that the driver is black or suspected of being a rebel terrorist or just a smuggler, generally speaking. The Empire does not do a DWBs. Main reason being that Darth Vader is black, technically, because you never see under the hood. So, that's good enough. So, yeah, I mean, like, if you want, for example, of ungodly modifications that should not be possible using... you got this one! This thing basically had everything stripped off in favor of two absolutely gigantic laser cannons from a capital ship that could actually damage a Star Destroyer if they got lucky. So, yeah, I mean, why not? You know, why not? This is the kind of things Krillins drive around in. This is a Krillian pimp mobile. This kind of thing. This one's a particularly interesting example of the aforementioned growing guns and missile launchers when you try to arrest them. This one's got missile launchers, multiple banks of missile launchers hidden under the side panels here. It's supposed to be an anti-piracy vessel, which is, like, hilarious. Because it's exactly the kind of thing that pirates would use to capture, in a trap. So, yeah, it all depends on who's using it, huh? This one. The armed freighter, which has, like, it has a ridiculous amount of guns. It just does. I mean, seriously, look at that arsenal. Like, two ion cannons, triple blasters, two of them fire length forward, a lot of concussion missile launchers. So, yeah, I mean, like, this thing is literally not designed. This thing couldn't be more clearly designed to break through police blockades and roadblocks if it was, like, it might as well just say on the front, you know, blockade smasher, because fuck the Empire, and, you know, yeah, here's, like, another example of a civilian pseudo-gunship. Like, look at this thing. It's a miniature CR-4, it's a miniature Correllian Corvette, also known as the Blockade Runner. So, yeah, like, you know, you can see why certain people, like the Empire, might have problems with the Correllian, ship-building philosophy. It's like, you know, this planet I heard of where they've got these trucks called Toyotas that everybody puts guns on instead of, you know, using them for transport. Well, Correllian ships are kind of the same thing, except they've got the gun mounts built in and they're designed to be super customizable. So you can basically turn them into just about anything with enough time and parts and patience. Well, I even heard of, like, one of these things that has an internal hangar bay with four A-wings. I mean, how would you even do that? Like, seriously. Like, why not? I mean, it would be cheaper to... It's just... Yeah. Like, Correllians love to pimp out their ships. Is what I'm saying. Here's another one with a fearsome frontal armament. I'm sure it's not for pirates and not for stopping for people from pulling you over. This one just a relatively normal freighter, and when I say relatively normal, I mean there's no such thing as a normal Correllian ship. They're all modified to some extent. And this one, I mean, seriously, look at this. It's like It's like Slave, it's like Boba Fett Slave 1 and the Millennium Falcon had sex and this was their baby. Like, seriously, the Heavy Courier. Okay, I'm just loving the ship naming conventions here. A Heavy Courier. This thing has 2 twin-linked heavy laser cannons on each of the wings back here. Four light laser cannons, all fire links, an auto blaster, which is kind of like a space machine gun, and a lot of concussion missile launchers. So, I mean, this thing is like a literal gunboat, just pretending to be a legitimate civilian ship. And that's its normal configuration. They come that way. You'd understand why the Empire shut production of these things down pretty damn quick, because, I mean, yeah, they're ridiculously well-armed for a courier. And here's another example of interesting nomenclature. The quote-unquote escort freighter. Right. This thing is, at least on paper, this is the official version, supposed to be used for combating pirates and protecting other less well-armed freighters. So basically, it's part of a convoy escort in territory that's not, you know, safe. Now, I would buy this excuse, especially in certain areas of the galaxy. The only problem is that this thing is absurdly well-armed. I mean, twin heavy laser cannons and a turret, like 8 auto blasters and the forward mandibles there, a heavy load of torpedoes, which, by the way, I mean, these things could deal serious damage to a Star Destroyer on their own. So, you know, given the fact that this thing can do severe damage to a ship that's over a proper warship over a kilometer long, and is there's this ship from a galaxy far, far away called the Defiant, I've heard about, which this thing is like kind of similar in that all of its weapons are basically pointed forward. So I don't know how much use this would be for legitimate convoy patrol duty, because you need to be able to kind of, you know, shoot in all directions to just... The idea is supposed to be to chase them off, not necessarily destroy them. So why are all this thing's guns in the forward arc? Especially its really nasty proton torpedoes. I mean, it doesn't make any sense for a so-called protection ship, right? These things are clearly clearly not even disguised, like attack ships designed for runs on larger ships. Just saying. I mean, this thing is not what it says it is. I mean, just look at this thing. An aggressive profile, all of its guns mounted forward, or able to be mounted pointed forward at the very least. You know, so yeah, I'm calling BS. So, that's my opinion on the, oh yes, join the Empire. That's my opinion on the Correllian shopping catalogue 2020 edition. Yes, it's, as you can see, even the ships that aren't ridiculously well-armed can easily be modified for, well, alternative usages. I mean, it literally says on the front of the catalog, pilots, privateers, smugglers. Yeah, like, seriously, you know. So, this is Darth Vader, Krillin's all pirates, smugglers, and are traitors wanted by the smugglers, pirates, and their ships are designed for that kind of thing. Seriously, how does nobody else see this but the Empire? Goodbye.